Peter. It was a very informative presentation. Thank you so much. Moving on, we have our next very interesting speaker, Ardhanan Gilavizade. I hope I'm able to pronounce your name right.
Thank you.
Yes. So, regarding Ardhanan, if you will find saffron growing indoors, you would always see Ardhanan over there. If you see any mushroom growing news, you will always find Ardhanan there. So I am glad to welcome Ardhanan to present on cultivation of the most expensive spices, decreasing its price of transportation, and engaging other industries to vertical farming. Ardhanan, the stage is yours.
Hello, everybody. Thanks for having me. Thanks for GVF, Vertical Global Farming, for this event. The history of vertical farming is the very simple. This is near the 90% decrease in water consumption, near the 60% using the fertilizer, near the 70% decrease in all kinds of diseases and disorder of agricultural crops, increasing the areas under the cultivation, all kinds of the crops like saffron, you mentioned to saffron, the other spices, and the mushroom. You know, there is a reality with increasing urban population. All of us, we do not have access to very big environment. For example, in London, in Munich, in other big cities, Dubai, the Madrid, the access to this environment, very big environment, it is very hard. In vertical farming, I mentioned increasing the areas under cultivation so that in growing saffron indoors, 100 square meters, you know, 100 square meters is equal with 1 hectare. In 100 square meters, we can put near the 6,000 kilograms of bulbs. With the shelving system, 1 hectare outside, because there is one surface, also have access to near just 4,000 or 5,000 kilograms. Also, yield of the saffron in 100 square meters per year is near the 10 kilograms of saffron. In the outside, 1 hectare with the equal using of the bulk is near the 4 kilograms of the dry saffron. All of us in the big cities that I mentioned, in London, in Munich, Dubai, Tehran, New Delhi, all of us accessing to this environment, 100 square meters, 20 square meters, 10 square meters, 5 square meters, 15, all of us we have in our homes, in our house, and I have numerous trainees across the world that they are working in their house with their father, with his family. I have a trainee that works with the son. I have a trainee that works with the father and the family, and they are working in this business, growing saffron indoors, growing all cultivation, all exotic mushrooms, and they have, they can earn a lot of money. Also, agricultural activities, this business, and the preventing all kinds of mental diseases like depression, like anxiety, like OCD. This is that I know it's a session about the vertical farming, but I would like to mention to this. And vertical farming allows to you, you know, that work. Your city is not important. You're from Africa is not important. You're India, every corner, even in this case, with vertical farming, we can have the business of the vertical farming, growing saffron indoors, growing, for example, the ginger indoors, exotic mushrooms, growing all kinds of insects. We have scorpions in the vertical farming because everything is under control, okay? And I mentioned to the cities, for example, the New Delhi with 20 square meters. For starting, there are heavy questions. For example, I'm from South Africa. Can I start? Yes. You do not have any limitation in your region, in your city. Do you have any limitation in time? We do not have any time. For example, in the outside, for example, some countries like Iran, for example, Greece, Morocco, Algeria, Israel, these countries, for example, in the outside, they can cultivate saffron, but other the spices. But with the growing saffron indoors or growing spices indoors, the most expensive spice, the growing exotic mushroom, we can cultivate every corner in the world that you are watching me, you are here, this my world, because everything under control. Even, for example, have a 60, my recommendation for the my training is start with 60 square meters. The 60 square meters is the suitable for starting. In the 60 square meters, you can put near the 4,000 kilogram of balls. Between 60 square meters to 100 square meters. For example, if you have 1,000 square meters, okay, the good news, you should divide for control, for better control of the environmental factors. And I think you receive the answer. Every word that you leave, you can start growing saffron indoors. Only thing that you need to completely cover. In your house, okay, you can. In your restroom, in your bathroom, in the every room, every chamber that you have in the access. This is very important. This place for yourself. For example, for the starting, for the testing, even you can start with the tent. I have a training work with the toilet. For example, this is the clothes, everything, and start with the growing saffron indoors with this. We do not have any limitation in the time. Also, with vertical farming, we do not have any limitation in the working. But the only things that you need for starting for 60 square meters, it is the shelves. The material of the shelves is the very simple, is the iron or aluminum. But you should find this very cheap, because the cost of the investing, you want to invest in this project, is very important. You should spend the money that is necessary, and you shouldn't spend the money that is unnecessary. For example, the material of the wood, for example, for shelves, you can spend near 1,000 euros. For 60 square meters, you can spend near the 25,000 euros. Unfortunately, this is our task. For example, Ardalan Ghilavizadeh is a company, for example, that produce LED, produce light, and Mediterranean live in the New Delhi. The New Delhi, for example, the city in the Iran, in the India, in Europe, 24 out of 7 weeks, we have access to sun. And okay, because I produce the artificial light, LED, I, for example, offer the LED lamp, for example, the shelves with the colorful. This is the wrong. We should simplify. We shouldn't complicate this process. This process of vertical farming is the very simple, but needs to suitable knowledge. The shelving system and the control of the environment, like carbon dioxide, temperature, light, and humidity. About the light, for example, Ardalan produce and manufacture the light LED lamp. And in New Delhi, we have access to sun. Sun is completely free and have the mix of the variety of the light, 350 nanometers to 650 nanometers, the mix of the blue light there. Okay, if my training, for example, you should extend a shelf with very colorful with the LED, okay, and it's not necessary, okay? If I force, for example, the my training, purchase the near 22,000, this investing has a wrong. My training in near future faced with the problem, okay, it doesn't have economical justification for me. Okay, I harvested the numerous flowers of saffron because he or she spent the money that is not necessary. For example, you know, the all crops, the all spices, the all exotic mushrooms that we grew in the completely cover, you need to variety range of the 12 to 28 centigrade. For example, saffron. In the summer, we purchase the bulbs at the middle of the summer. In the 1 month, you should provide for the bulbs in the environment 25 centigrade. Okay? In the autumn, the growing saffron needs to 20 centigrade. After that, you should give a cold shocking during 3 days. After that, 17 centigrade. Finish. This is the story of temperature for growing saffron indoors. This is the process. 25 centigrade in summer, 20 at the beginning of the autumn, 17 at the 12 centigrade, the middle of the autumn, at the end of the autumn, exactly like this, the 1st December, that we need to temperature near 17 centigrade. Okay, if my trainee live in the India, in the warm region, he or she should focus on the air handling unit and the chiller cooling system. Okay? It is very big wrong. Instead of spending money for 5,000, for example, he or she should spend 5,000 euros, for example, for air handling unit. And instead of this, okay, you should purchase the LED, because Ardalan doesn't produce air conditioner or doesn't produce the chilling system, produce LED. This is wrong. We should simplify, we should clarify, and we should completely clear, completely frank, and the other, the points of the region that they need to spend the money. They spend the money the suitable time, you know? I'm not like disagree with the LED. Some region, for example, in the Norway, in Sweden, we do not have access. Some people work in the underground, okay? There is not some, okay. The producer of LED should offer your products, the suitable product. Not, for example, in the region, we have 5 farms and we have 5 million factory manufacturers of LED, numerous. This is wrong, it doesn't need. We have the numerous over 5 million producer, for example, the LED, the, I'm not angry, but this is, I would like that to say the reality about the sun. For example, my granny live in New Delhi and have access to the sun, okay, with a little a window and a suitable with the knowledge related to carbon dioxide. We did it. Sometimes it doesn't need to spend money for the access to light. You know, for example, in the 4 factors, that is very necessary, the cultivation, all kind of mushroom, the growing saffron, the growing spices, if you want to start the mushroom, only thing that you need, the temperature, light, humidity, carbon dioxide. About the light at carbon dioxide, completely related to your knowledge. You should want to learn how to play with this environment, in these factors. But the temperature is completely in your money. For example, my trainee live in the New Delhi in Mumbai, have access to sun, and has a region. For example, in autumn, I mentioned that he need to 20 centigrade or 17 centigrade. If you couldn't control the temperature to 17 and temperature arrives to 17 centigrade, and Mumbai is the city that have a region, for example, in autumn, 25 centigrade, 28 centigrade, my task as a company, as the give, for example, the consultation, if the, if I should explain for him, you need to air handling unit and chiller and cooling system, okay? You have the sun, it doesn't need you to spend. You should spend money for the air handling unit. You should control, and in the New Delhi, you can purchase the air handling unit and decrease. In the online, for example, I have a trainee in the Norway, in the Sweden, in the Munich, okay? It doesn't need the purchasing any chiller, any air handling unit, any cooling system, because he live in Munich. In the autumn, that I need to 12 or 17 centigrade, the weather automatically, the God automatically provide for me the temperature, the suitable temperature. Okay, that this is our task, the company related to vertical farming. If I, the vertical, the people that work in university related to vertical farming, the, for example, the company, the gatherer, the numerous people, this is the company that manufactures the, all equipment related to the vertical farming, we should offer in the suitable time. If the if I have the customers in the work underground, if for a special crowd, I should offer for people. And for example, I gave a message. I gave an example. For example, I gave an example. For example, if you have access to the sun and you work with saffron, you do not need to LED system. Okay, this is a very clear. I have experience near the over 12 years about the saffron. For example, some crops, I don't know. Maybe in the city that have access to the sun, maybe a little necessary. But my recommendation over, because my recommendation always is that if you have access to the sunlight, you can use the sunlight with the change, the dimension of the window, you know, and another things. About the growing saffron, indoors and the spices, the good news is this doesn't need. You have having any agricultural background. We do not have any limitation in age. I have a trainee that is 12 years old. I have a trainee 70 years old. And all city in the different countries work in this culture. And another good news is the 80% of equipment that you purchase for this vertical farming for exotic mushroom is the same. For example, if you work in the growing saffron indoors, for example, 3 months, your chamber, your environment is in building. You can work, for example, the purchase, the compost of the exotic mushroom, the compost of shiitake, the compost of the button mushroom, the compost of the shimej mushroom, the thing is, the compost of the lion's mane, hevelisyon. This is a good news. 80% or 90% of equipment for example, the growing saffron is the same for exotic mushrooms, for ginger growing, for blueberry, for example, for other crop, other scorpions, insects, and it doesn't need, for example, if we want to, for example, change for the 3 months that our greenhouse is empty, we shouldn't purchase another things for another crops. You know, for example, in the reishi mushroom and the saffron, in the controlled environment, is a completely near. For example, the reishi mushroom and saffron, because the reishi mushroom needs to over 1,000 lux, and the saffron is also need to over 1,000 lux. In the temperature, in the vegetative phase, is the needs. The saffron is to 25 centigrade, also reishi mushroom to 25 centigrade. The good news is that 80% of the equipment that we use is the same, and it's very important to starting. We should suitable. This is the exactly like a structure of the building. We should provide. This is the majority of my trainees provide the equipment that can use, have a different crops in the during 1 year, have experience, in addition saffron, have a ginger, in addition have a exotic mushroom, shimej, shiitake, king oyster, okay? And also the suitable. About the growing saffron indoors, in the summer you purchase, in the September you purchase the bulbs. In the weight of the bulb is very important, should be around near over 15 grams. In the 4,000, in the 60 square meters, you can put around 4,000 kilograms of bulbs. And each 1,000 kilograms of bulbs gives you around 1 kilogram dry saffron. If the best condition, you can have also from 1,000 kilograms of bulbs, 1.5 kilogram dry saffron. It means 60 square meters gives you every year around 6 kilograms of saffron. If you have the 100 square meters, 10 kilogram dry saffron per year, and the price of the saffron these days has doubled. You know, for example, each gram of saffron in your country, in India, actually is the near the 500 rupees in each gram of saffron. In Italy, 30 euros. In the Germany, is near the 18 euros. Each kilogram of saffron here in Germany is near the 18,000 euros. Each gram of the saffron in the London is 10 euros. In the Morocco, is the each gram of saffron is 4 euros. In the Algeria, 2 euros. They have very the price fluctuation. You know, with vertical farming, we can fit. Okay, we can fit this temperature, and the gradually we have the good dealer, bad dealer. Good dealer, always is good. The dealer, I do not have any problem with the dealer. But this vertical farming, the decreasing the shipping, for example, we have a country, for example, about the crops, for example, the ginger growing in the Africa. Okay, in the south of southeast Africa, we in the center of the Europe, we produce a ginger, okay, and every people in India, okay, you can produce in your home, in your Africa, and the Israeli ginger. It doesn't mean the African people worry about that, okay. In my country, in the outside, ginger easily grew. And the Europe every year, 1 million or $2 million for this exporting. And okay, vertical farming is eliminating my business. No, this is completely wrong. Exactly. I would like that to speak with the farmers that live in Africa. Even, for example, you have the ginger in your country. Do you have received the real benefit of the ginger outside? Not exactly. The 99% of this problem related that back to the dealers. Bad dealers are getting $1 million or $1 billion or some crops for this And with vertical farming, we eliminate all obstacles near the time, near the age. In your house, you can come become a farmer, okay, near the, your sound, the family near you, you know. And this, it doesn't mean that, for example, the nation's crops, for example, if I, the some crops that farmers, it doesn't mean that your country, your crops, your nation's crops is has eliminated gradually. No, it doesn't mean. And with the vertical farming, we have the balance between prices in the growing saffron indoors. In the summer, when you purchase the 4 months, you are engaged with the growing saffron indoors. In the summer, in the September, you purchase the bulbs for 60 square meters. For 60 square meters, around 4,000 kilograms of bulbs. You should, before that, they provide the shelves in the fourth floor, in the wooden boxes, without soil, without even the perlite, even with only the wooden boxes, only 25 centigrade in summer, humidity around 60%, and the light with the sound, if you have access, a little a dimension of the window is the 50 by 100 centimeter, and you will, in the autumn, you should decrease the temperature near the 20 centigrade. After 1 month, 17 centigrade, 12 centigrade, the cold shocking, after that 17 centigrade, and you will see the beautiful flowers in your wooden boxes. After that, you can keep also the flowers in your greenhouse with a little, if you consider the height of the wooden boxes with 20 centimeters. If it is possible, I would like to share some PowerPoint. Do you agree, Afshin? And I would like that. And is it, I have a question. My PowerPoint, is it visible?
Yes, it is visible.
For example, in a model, for example, for vertical farming, the meat, the vertical farming is very simple. Two row of shelves, the red part is the air handling unit, and the pipe at the middle of two shelves is the plastic dock or aeration channel. I told you, this depending all of your knowledge. With the shelves, this is also in the shelves, air handling unit, cooling system. With this simple system, you will be able everywhere. And you have all of things you have can access to these. So for example, the shelves, the plastic dock, you know, these are the chiller for the country that is very warm. For example, in India, this is the heating system for Deutschland, for example, has a winter and air handling unit. This problem, for example, the chiller, cold water inside the air handling unit. Air handling unit, both of country, cold and warm region, uses because this is provide for us air. But in winter, that we have the hard winter, this boiler works, and boilers, warm water connected to the heater, connected to the air handling unit, and air handling unit provide for us the warm air. Also in the summer or the countries like India that the weather is very warm, the chiller cold water connected to the air handling unit, and the task of air handling unit provides cold air. You know, to all chaos, we need to air, not the water, you know. And also, this is the growing saffron indoors. As you can see, this is very visible. The bulbs of saffron in my hand, there is not any soil, there is not any bed, there is not any water. This is very clear. The wooden boxes, the shelves, only wooden boxes. You should play with the temperature, 25 centigrade, 20 centigrade. Also, another piece of my growing saffron indoors, wooden boxes, the shelves, harvesting of the flowers. Each 1,000 kilogram of bulbs of saffron gives you around 1 kilogram dry of saffron. Okay? And each 1 kilogram of fresh flower gives you 20 grams. Okay? Harvesting of the flowers of the, you know, this is, and also the shelves and the harvesting of the shelf. Also another form of the growing saffron indoors. Very simple, the wooden boxes, the shelves, and other pictures. Harvesting of the saffron. These are the name of the petal. After harvesting, we should separate the purple part of the red part. And the red part is the business that is very expensive. You know, this purple has not the valuable cost. Another of the growing saffron indoors, these are very simple. Another that in my right hand is the dry saffron and the other hand the bulbs of saffron. Each 1,000 kilogram, each 1,000 kilogram of bulbs of saffron gives you around 1 kilogram dry saffron. These are diseases. This is another growing saffron indoors, and also another vertical farming of the saffron. Another vertical saffron. The saffron in the market every year increases because the, you know, 98% of my terrains doesn't have any agriculture, but the saffron, I think it is head of the business. Mushroom, button mushroom also good. This is the reishi mushroom, the most expensive mushroom, because my time is a little, and I would like to show you the reishi mushroom in the vertical farming. Reishi mushroom, the reishi mushroom, the red reishi mushroom, king oyster mushroom. You know, facilities is the same, 80% is the same, and you have the equipment that you purchase for your saffron. You can also, after saffron, you can king oyster. For example, in this slide, you can see in this shiitake, you know, it is very clear. The shelves, the air handling unit, boiler, it is hydroponic fodder, forage, also another. This is amazing, the hydroponic for the horses, you know. My recommendation, in the vertical farming, you can grow everything, insects. This is the leeches farming. Leeches, India and Chinese know, and the Russia people, the leeches. This is the great surgeon. You know, also did vertical farming. This is also the insulation, the wooden boxes that I mentioned for starting. This is the air handling unit that you need for starting of the growing saffron indoors. Another air handling unit, another, and also that mentioned at the first of my meeting about this, you know, but a window for light in your door, you can provide the light, the suitable light. Also plastic duct, because we need to every year the suitable and balance here every corner of the our chamber. Also these devices that show us to us the carbon dioxide. This is very important, the amount of the carbon dioxide in the flowering of the saffron. We need to around 800 ppm of the carbon dioxide. The lux meters, we need to over 1000 lux. Also another thing. Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much, Adlan. Thank you so much for a very interesting presentation about